Atrial fibrillation is a really common disorder. It affects about 2 to 5 million people in the United States, 30 million worldwide at least. Normal heart rhythm is set by the pacemaker here called the sinus node, and waves spread like ripples in a pond. In AFib, you have something that's very much less organized. We used to think that atrial fibrillation was random and therefore not really something you could map. So using work that we developed, we for the first time started mapping where the conduction patterns were. And what we found was this disorder is caused by localized, organized driving regions. In many patients, the organized central regions were like spinning tops, like rotors, sending off chaos. So what was really interesting was many of these rotor areas lay outside where you would normally do an ablation, including in different portions of the left atrium over here, as well as in the right atrium, where typically we hadn't even been applying ablation therapy in patients with atrial fibrillation. So then we spent many years to actually get the software to the point where we could actually do the mapping during a case and then apply therapy. I've been performing ablations using a new technique we've developed, firm focal impulse and rotor modulation. The actual ablation time in firm is very short, only about 18 minutes. We put catheters through the groins, put the basket in, see the map. We then pass the catheter up into the heart to roughly this area. We then identify the area, then we burn over it, typically 3 centimeters squared, which takes about 5 to 10 minutes. And that's one rotor gone. Then we do it again. And then when we're done with the right, we cross from right to left atrium and do the same in the left. And then we're done with firm. We've had great successes, but there are many unanswered questions that we are in the process of studying about where this type of ablation firm will eventually fit. So I think that the number one principle is there can't be a one size fits all for atrial fibrillation. You tailor. I personally do firm ablation in every patient, which includes patients with early stage disease, medium and advanced stages. We've noticed that the eventual recurrence rate we're seeing at 1 year is about 20%, and at 2 to 3 years is about 30%. So it's quite good. It's been a general trend in the field of AF that it's very common to need a second procedure. Our data shows that that is less true for firm, and we hope that continues to be true in future studies.